We thank you very much for the introduction. Thank you very much for the opportunity to give you that presentation. So the topic is basically shared data economy and privacy. So I have 20 minutes given, and actually I'm here basically on very short notice. So excuse me if not everything is smooth. I basically modified a presentation from a colleague who was supposed to come here and made my own story. So cloud computing is associated with several issues. One issue is security assurance, of security trust, complexity, interoperability, and high scalability computing powers. And that setting influences very much how we in Europe thinking about data security. So traditionally, data security, personal data protection relates to cross-border flows of personal data. And traditionally, it works in this way. You have within the EU a data subject. That's a person about which you collect information. And there's a data controller, which basically defines the purpose for the collection and does something with the data. And he maybe can subcontract within the EU without much restriction. But as soon as it crosses the EU border, there are some limitations. You have to apply some due diligence and make sure that the data importer is in compliance with comparable security requirements. So, for example, data flow from Germany to Vietnam. Vietnam is a data importer who acts as a data processor. The data processor maybe doesn't know anything about the final intent of the data controller, and his job is just to process according to the instruction. But the problem is he also maybe exported to a subcontractor. So it's already a very complex situation in legal terms and compliance terms. So how cloud computing comes in? Basically, cloud computing, if you use software as a service or infrastructure as a service, the cloud computing services export data. So there is basically no active doing in exporting data, just using Office 365 and you might export data. Or you use Dropbox and you might export data. But who actually is exporting the data? Who knows how the overall ICT supply chain works? Who is finally liable if data are leaking and compromised and popping up somewhere else in the world? And there are many related issues which organization exporting data directly or indirectly have to take care. There are legal uncertainties, contractual issues. In Europe, we're using for export of data something which is called standard contractual clause, that at least from the legality of a certain document, it is waterproof that each party engaging in this data exchange knows what are his responsibilities. We're implementing binding corporate rules, especially for data within larger organization. You have to assess, you do some due diligence about the capabilities in terms of securities of the data importer. And on the other side, also you have to make sure there's a certain competencies in understanding EU requirements. There must be somebody like a personal data protection official. So it's quite a complex issue. But now it is just getting very fuzzy. What does that constitute? If I drop something on my shared drive on Dropbox, that was a data export, and a data processor can be somewhere. And who understands that situation? To make it more complicated, one cloud service provider builds on another cloud service provider. So you have maybe a cloud service provider one who operates at a site, at a location in one country, and he uses a platform as a service located in another country, and he basically interacts with API with another software as a service provider. This could be distributed over the whole world. And if there's something going wrong at the code level, in the data storage level, who understands the situation? What are the legal consequences? And then we have this, let's say, this Breaking technologies, big topic here in Singapore, Internet of Things, big data, smart building. In Germany, Industry 4.0, smart grid, BPOs. These are all industries which are very much enabled to cloud solutions. So you see here something wrong in that picture. This is actually, the cloud is normally above. But here it's down, because that is an enabler of all the technology. All the technologies relies on cloud computing. That is an enabler. That means all the issues we just discussed in the previous slide relates to all the technology trends. So, and there are sometimes very surprising things. For example, in the area of smart grid, I have worked 2 years in Japan in the area of smart grid security. And I learned a little bit about it. So if you run a smart grid in Europe, maybe the smart meter reading is done by a BPO somewhere in the world. And if the smart meter is working at a certain frequency, it is possible to analyze energy consumption profile of individuals, which gives immense a lot of information about an individual. It's not only that you know when an individual somewhere in Germany is out of his house and somebody in Russia reading the data and can send back to some criminal organization data about somebody who is not in his house, because the reading of the data. This is a huge impact on privacy, but it's much more, there's much more possibility to read out from that profile. You can see what kind of TV program somebody is watching from the energy profile. You can see when somebody is switching on his coffee machine. You can know if there are two people under the shower or one people under the shower. This is all going over the cloud via a simple service like metering service, distributed over application in a smart net. This is especially in Germany, I'm from Germany, this is a very frightening situation. And in Germany, people are traditionally very, very concerned about privacy because of history reason. You know, the German history, the Dritte Reich, the Nazi era, everything, the killing of millions of people was based on gathering data and then systematically analyzing data and killing people. So in Germany, we have a very, very bad perception about somebody steps in our privacy. This, in Germany, in one area of Germany, there was the first personal data protection law. This was something like 72, electronic data protection in Germany. So Germany is also leading here in Europe. So if you look a little bit to Germany, you will know what is influence on Europe in the regulatory requirement. So as a business in the field of cloud computing services, you're confronted with many, many different standards. MTCS, you know. But MTCS from a European perspective is coming way up the ladder here. Actually, it starts with a change in the EU personal data directive to the personal data protection regulation, which is actually a positive step for many players. You have to deal with model contracts, binding corporate rules. There's a safe harbor agreement, which is not more valid. And there's a bunch of cloud computing related standards, which all are somehow applicable to as a means to demonstrate, to give assurance and provide trust in your cloud operations. But which of that is relevant for you? What is the good practice standard? What is necessary? How is the relationship to regulatory requirements? In which industry you are? Are you in a credit card industry? Are you in Singapore operating, participating in public tenders? It's a tremendous knowledge you have to acquire to in that cloud business to not basically to get lost in the complexity. So in Europe, so TÜV Rheinland is based in Germany. We assisting customer to deal with this complexity in the cloud, the regulatory requirements. So we have, for example, clients who want to collect data, to aggregate data based on their international operations. They want to aggregate them in one database, analyze them, and to serve the customer worldwide best, yeah? Making failure reports, complaint management, collecting names of individuals. And how do you do that? Any cloud solution enables you technically, but what do you have to know? I mean, what are you collecting in Singapore or in Thailand or in China? Is it okay if you import them? What could be the consequences? So how do you know all these regulatory requirements applicable in all countries you are dealing with? So you offer from Germany maybe a cloud service, like Amazon is doing based on the US. This is tremendous challenge. Okay, and then what is personal data and what is not personal data? For example, recently was an incident about a spying application which was reading energy consumption based on your location. I think it's an iPhone application. So a party can analyze the path to Singapore based on your energy consumption because it's different depending on your position related to the next radio station. Yeah? And from that you can profile basically geolocation. So until that technology was published, nobody considered your battery drain as personal data, right? It was free, no limitation in terms of personal data protection. This changed from one day to another. And the concept what is personal data and what not differs in every country. The idea of privacy, I was living in Japan a long time. I was there around 2000. And as I started that business, personal data protection, all my Japanese colleagues asked me, what do you mean with privacy? In Asia, in generally, the concept of privacy is very different. I mean, you grow up maybe five sisters in one room. You are living with your parents until you marry. And if you are even 25, you're coming later than 10 o'clock home, your mother beat you up. Yeah, there is no privacy in many Asian countries. So, and there is no idea about, like in Germany, about a personal sphere. So I am German, my daughter is German, she was 2-3 years, and then basically she threw me out of the room and says, privacy, don't disturb me. Eh? So something like a display outside, don't come in, you have to knock. And I, as a father, I have to respect that. It's a totally different thing. So if you, as a cloud service provider or data exporter, export to other countries where there's no idea about privacy, that's a huge risk. It's not that necessary people make a malicious activity. They're selling your information without knowing that they're doing anything wrong. In Japan, in the year 2000, it was possible that you could sell on the internet a database with 10,000 of data records about pregnant women, with the date when they deliver, where they live, where they live, the address, and you could send basically Pampers and other baby accessory in an advertisement campaign, and this was totally legal. That changed in a couple of years in Japan drastically. But again, that is to illustrate how complex it is. Yeah? So if we in Germany assume anybody in Vietnam, in Cambodia or Indonesia has any idea about what we consider as privacy, there's no way. Yeah? So it's not only a legal issue, a standard issue, it's a cultural issue and a technology issue. So that company faces that issue. Just what is personal identifiable information? You find that out. Then, the objective basically was to consolidate all this data, having something like a customer relation management database, and they adapted various cloud service solutions, but the way to realize it was very complicated, and Trip Reinhardt assisted them in finding out the solutions and basically in documenting clearly data flows. If you don't know where data flows, within the application also, if you don't know where they cross the border, you have no chance to exercise a process of governance. So we have done that. And also to basically develop necessary binding corporate rules between different affiliates spread it over Europe and in the world. That was our assistance. At the end, they worked with several encryption technologies and restriction of data flows, and they made it done. But that was a project which needed a lot of assistance, a lot of analysis, and now they're pretty happy with their cloud-based solution. But as I try to illustrate, this is not done from one day to another if you're working in a global network. Okay, at the end, what you have to take care is manage your compliance. Managing compliance can be a formal issue. Be compliant with PCI DSS. Either you are certified or not. So if you're not certified and if you're a payment gateway, you basically have no license to process data. So you have to be in compliance. However, to be in compliance doesn't mean necessary that that risks are addressed appropriately. Your compliance program will assist you only for your risk management as good as the standard is and as good as the auditors are. There are many programs in the world where compliance has nothing to do with risk management or IT security. It's only about the risk of non-compliance, which is different from a technical risk or legal risk. So depending on which sector you're working, different standards are applicable. To start in an international setting, it's always good to start with ISO standards. If you have a specific target, you should look to the national standards. Then ensuring basically that you monitor access to personal data, ensuring you have a governance about your data flow, using encryption whenever it is possible, and make sure that people know what they're doing if they're sending out certain data outside of the EU. Documentation. All the certification programs emphasize a lot on documentation, but what that documentation means is documentation to ensure that you can provide enough evidence that you have done due diligence if you're exporting data. And exporting data means including exporting data without knowing it by using cloud computing solution. So you should have clear documentation about what kind of APIs you use, where are the data flows, where are sensitive information processed, and what is the purpose of the processing? And how do you ensure that your third parties, your vendors, understand this and they process data only for the same purpose as you basically order them to do? Okay, you keep track of all that regulatory requirement and then you are ready to do. But to do that in a global context, you need a lot of advice and knowledge, which is normally not present at a cloud service provider because that is not their business. So I just would like to invite you to contact TÜV Rheinland if you need assistance. Okay, this is my colleague here in Germany. If you're from Judop, that would be your contact point. I'm here in Singapore. If you have interest to learn more, then please feel free to contact us.